Well, it's a story that continues to shock the community and raises many questions.
The young mother who took a baby to Queens Medical Center then apparently lied about the child being hers. And it didn't have to happen, thanks to Hawaii's safe haven law. But it turns out there's a surprising lack of education about that law, and we want to know why. That's where we bring in Breanne Randall, who joins us with our top story. Breanne?
Justin, the real story behind this issue, word of mouth does not seem to cut it. To get the message out about Hawaii's baby safe haven law, Representative John Mizuno says he'll throw in his own money to change that and make the law more visible. These are two types of signs that other states have posted around hospitals, firehouses, and police stations to educate the public. Mizuno has about 8 of these and is ready to post them up around town. In fact, he's heard from two states that could send us additional signs for that use, or he'd be willing to pay for more himself. But not every baby safe haven site has been open to accepting them.
So we've contacted a couple of hospitals and they just didn't feel comfortable about us putting the signs by their emergency rooms.
Representative Mizuno said he'd come down tonight or even tomorrow to screw in signs.
If that's what he is willing to do, I think the administration would be willing to talk with him about that.
The next step would also be to contact fire stations and police stations and see if they'll allow us to do that.
Other hospitals we asked said they too will consider posting signs. And the Honolulu Fire Department says the signs are a good idea and will talk it over with the city. Honolulu police, fire, and the hospitals we all called today, they all say they do educate their employees about the law and the procedure for accepting newborn babies. Breanne Randall, KHON2 News.